During the debate, the Democrat public saw for the first time that they were deceived. They were deceived by the DNC and the U.S. mainstream media. This is the first time that the public knew conclusively that they had been lied to by our own media. The media had hidden all the evidence of Joe's frailty, feebleness, wandering around, all the times he fell down. Democrats, this is not the only thing that the media has been deceiving you about. The media played a big part in deceiving the public about the virus, the vaccines, the lockdowns, the masks, ivermectin, HCQ, smearing people, smearing opponents, many, many others. The media takes their orders from their bosses, the corporate owners. The very richest people in the world, the elites, own those corporations. Those very same elite multi-billionaires also own the pharmaceutical corporations, the military-industrial complex corporations, the six big entertainment multinational corporations like Comcast, Disney, and they own the largest stock market funds in the world, BlackRock, Vanguard, State Street, JP Morgan. Through the years, they have created a little network where they literally control the entire planet Earth. As soon as a company becomes big, they buy it, or they just buy a controlling amount of shares. These same billionaire elites own the banking corporations, the credit card corporations, and even the Federal Reserve, which is not federal, and it's not a reserve of any kind either. It's a privately owned corporation. Check it out. Do your research. And there is a group of men in our military who found out about this, figured it out. Although it took years, they have hatched a plan to expose, charge, and tribunal for any crimes that they've committed, these elite billionaires. And we are just about to see the culmination of this sting, the largest sting in world history. The noose is tightening around the neck of the elite globalists, and they are panicking and they are desperate to stop it. But God willing, the white hats will be successful. The goal of the good guys is to destroy the cabal globalists with as little bloodshed as possible. They are afraid that the Democrats, the liberals, the progressives will feel that their team is being attacked. No, it's not your team. Those people that are pretending to be on the Democrat Party side actually have their loyalty to the cabal, not the Democrats. They've been using you. They've conned you. They've deceived all of us, but it's being exposed. The sooner you know about it, the sooner you can detach. Keep your loyalty to your Democrat priorities, not to the cabal priorities. Democrats, I ask you, were you in favor of defunding the police? That was the cabal. Is it a Democrat policy that you're in favor of to promote transgenderism, sexualizing children at an early age, confusing them? That's not a Democrat policy. That has nothing to do with Democrats. That is cabal. Democrats, are you in favor of open border policies? That's not in favor of USA. That's in favor of the cabal. The cabal has infiltrated the Democrat Party severely. The cabal has also infiltrated the Republican Party, not to that much of an extent, but they have infiltrated the Republican Party. The shit is going to hit the fan in the later half of 2024. And the more people who know about this, who know about the behind-the-scenes activities of this corrupt worldwide network called the cabal, the better off we are, the less bloodshed. And hopefully we'll have success in destroying this very well-entrenched, powerful group that is not looking out for your best interests, the cabal. Do your research. Take the time. This is a very vital time in history.
Look at all the people around. Everybody's here for Trump.
I am a Democrat.
And who are you voting for?
Donald J. Trump.
What has AOC done for the Bronx?
She's done nothing for the Bronx. Nothing. Nothing's changed. Nothing's gotten any better.
Nothing. Absolutely nothing.
Let her come to the Bronx and let her come among us people that struggle. She doesn't even know what struggle is. We're not the silent majority no more. We need to get out and have conversations with our families, our friends. We need to stop being scared of losing our jobs when we're talking about our freedoms being on the line here. We don't need a Democrat to give us our power. We already have power because God is the one that sits on the throne, not a Democrat politician.
Amen.
This is a war in this country. And I don't call this a war lightly.
Because it turns out that the only way the globalists win is if you give in to fear. That is the only way they win. We, the people, can say no.
In closing, to all the Democrats, fellow Americans, in order to save America, save our country, and avoid a lot of bloodshed, we need you, Democrats, to wake up. Realize that you've been conned. You need to see that this is not just a normal election of Republicans versus Democrats. There's a third group, and this third group does not want to be known. They work best secretly, because then the Democrats blame the Republicans blame the Democrats. This third group doesn't want to be known. They don't want any blame. And this corruption network needs to be stopped. So please, don't just blindly believe anything heard in this video. Take the time, do your own research, dig. It's a very important time in history.
Please forward this link. And by liking and commenting, it helps for more people to see this by raising the algorithm. So please like and comment. Thank you.
I saw in him then the same character that I see in him today. And even though he has faced unimaginable tragedies, his optimism is undaunted. His strength is unshakable. His hope is undeterred.